pretty bad when you find typos and you wrote it. I get to give Christine a hard time about it.
What had happened?
There's a typo in this.
No, sir.
Yeah.
I thought I did it.
Yeah, well, John, what?
John, you want to wrap the gavel?
I'm sure I probably voted wrong.
I know, but I tried so hard to get it right. I just wanted to
meeting
get
open?
Something.
Selectman's meeting?
The first thing I want to do is apologize for you two guys. I don't know what the hell happened to me Thursday. I didn't even know I missed it until yesterday.
Oh yeah, well, John missed it too. So,
I don't know. I had it written down too.
Why not?
Well, we had a good time with all of you. The LRPC presentation and planning board. You were there. Yeah. See how much of a good time we had? Dave can't even remember.
I can just imagine.
I didn't know that all of these were invited.
Oh, yeah?
It's going to be one of those days. They all blend together now. I don't even know why I leave.
Oh, sorry, yeah, John is still reading all the stuff. All in the world. Light on that?
I don't know.
Okay.
$2,200 for the transfer station.
They go to the fire pit?
Well, actually, it's more.
And clean up the.
$1,300 to change. Yeah. For the transfer station.
That was Like I said, there was 2.5 loads of ash in there. But Dick inspected it. He likes it. He did have a suggestion.
Yeah, he told me. Put two berms up. I don't ever remember seeing two berms. No. I never did.
I don't remember, but there could have been at one time. But.
Do you know who that is?
No.
All things kind of go those
away.
Who wants it
first? Give me the Lenny, because that was going to get you to tell me who this is.
Oh, he's a troublemaker. Lives over near Lost Valley.
John?
What's that?
You know who that is? You really don't know who that is?
It's Bill. Can't read it.
It's Bill.
Oh. No, I didn't.
Yes. No. Yes, Papa.
What is he?
Oh my! I don't even. I never saw. Where? How did you even get this? Is it in the mail folder?
No, it was in this. Oh, the action folder.
How
mail
nice.
Folder.
Yeah,
that fellow gave it to me.
Oh.
Do we know what he's talking about? This is whose
property? And I do believe the last time I heard about this, the way the house is littered with crap.
Well, I guess we'll probably take coffee. You could probably get the health officer waiting on this later. Well, he's got this one.
I don't recall him necessarily talking about it. It has been mentioned before. So would you like me to take a coffee and ask Rebecca what she knows of this?
Sure. And I'll take a coffee too, just
yes.
Because...
I heard about it. I heard something about it. Yeah. I forget who was coming. I think it was Melissa, I think, actually. I said, that's how it was a good idea. And I know just the person to put on the budget committee, too.
Yeah. Since he's done a bunch of work.
was familiar with it.
You might want to read this at your own leisure. Supposed to initial these things.
Why initial one?
What's that, Dave?
No, I didn't. I didn't initial it.
No.
Cheryl was saying it's not the first time that he has complained about that.
Okay.
It's switching your grade. The one on the back of the box right this moment.
There's,
I'm getting that, the Spectrum contract.
Do you have it?
The Spectrum or the White Mouse?
I have that also.
That's what.
But you're here and it's your
the White Mouse cable. It is.
Yes.
I got that contract. It's Charter Communications, White Mouse. I'm not talking about that. This one. Franchise agreements. I don't have things in here. Time on a few.
Yeah, well, the bill comes in the name of it.
Does it really?
Yes, but I think time on. Okay. So it is the cable. We're all talking about the same thing with a different name.
Do they
that
have
is very
name?
Interesting.
They should have
I think
name?
This is their parent company, Spectrum's probably their
right.
spin-off for.
Sure, local.
But you have it?
I have a copy
yeah.
of the local sentence.
Yes. So I will sign mine in the
computer. And the one that you're talking about, the one that's correct.
Yes.
Yeah,
I had some stuff coming up. Dave, it was a thing for. It's about the school system and how they're calculating. Funds and stuff, our tax rate, and in fact, Town of Ospe is asking for a review, and they want members from the communities. That's why you get that big V for victim on your head as we sit here looking out in the audience. We should choose someone from the audience, that's what I think. What's that? Yeah. Yeah. You're welcome, man. Read it. John, did you get that actually? All the place tonight.
I saw this. Got my other side.
And did you? I gotta admit, I don't find the time to read, to watch any of the other towns, our town.
Yeah, they got whacked. And it's unfair.
The whole school tax unfair.
Yeah, that's true. They got hit 900,000.
Yeah, it's a big jump.
It's the formula.
Yeah.
There's got to be a way to put the brakes on some of that stuff. Budget committee? Is that what you're talking about? Yeah, well. Where I work, some people felt the bigger and more bloated you get for a department, the more important you are, because you get more money, more this, more. I don't know. Maybe we should go for an extended amount of coffee.
The long lunch?
Yes.
Beer and all that. Bring Lenny, you know that.
somebody will have to drink my share, so I'll just be on coffee.
I'm going to have a DD anyway.
Yeah.
We'll start off at breakfast and go into lunch and get this thing figured out.
You could take that long, too. Let me try to give you that long. Weeks.
Does Rebecca have this?
I asked Claudia to see that she gets it on.
They should put him back in the bus.
Wednesday. No, I think it was. No, he wasn't. He wasn't there on Thursday. Cause he called me on. I mean, Wednesday. He called me on Thursday and said Josh was there. So it's Thursday, Friday is what it should be.
Wow.
But he was there 2 days.
2 days.
Yeah.
But I cleaned out all the stuff behind. Good job. Of course, they had to dig a hole down in the woods there to bury all the ash and everything. That was the suggestion from the principal.
She knows what they're calling what's right.
Yeah. Well, she said when her girls get to middle school or daughter or something, she had to go buy one for her to complete some project. So.
So hard about
that. It's pretty easy.
You don't have to do it. You don't even have to leave your office.
I don't get it.
I saw it today and I might send myself in.
It's the way it's done.
I just can't figure out.
Said date should have been the 14th, because on his daily,
yeah,
it says 614, because that's the transfer station.
Well, I was more looking at the bottom line.
Yeah.
Which, sticker shot.
You gotta do what you gotta do, I guess.
I think it'll help that we started segregating things out so that we don't make a big pile and then...
Yeah. Yeah, we should have stayed on top of that pile.
We'll blame Henry for that.
Well, Mark said he'd been after... after us for over a year to clean it out, but I don't remember him saying anything. It's not to say he didn't.
Well, I just meant the whole process of not just lumping everything in a pile. Some of that. Anyway. This one?
Yeah.
There you go.
Oh no, the other one.
This is what I've gone through so far.
John, do you want copies of those in your...
No, this doesn't really have that. No, that's my copy of things, so...
It's just good, I just had it. And it, there it is, and then an extra four. An extra four.
Time Warner Cable is Spectrum.
about this one, Lane? The oil tank? Building 2? Station 2?
No, it's a diesel tank.
I thought they'd get away with that.
No, they have the diesel for the trucks. They did away with the oil tank.
That's why it was...
Yeah, it's diesel.
What's that, John?
Yeah.
Said closing up the shop. I lost. Things are done.
I'm all set.
You all set?
Yep.
Lever, please rise and for this pledge. Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America. Republic for which stands one nation
under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thanks, everyone. Come. Or, in this case, Dave. Okay, well, we just reviewed the matchup. The agenda review, the public hearing is at 6:30 tonight. And Lenny, you got something on a thing for 25 Old Town Road?
Yeah, you want to do that?
Yeah,
now?
Let's do that, yeah.
I got a complaint of septic running into the brook. So I went and looked at it. It's not running into the brook. It's getting down to the edge of the road, but it's coming right out of the person's lawn. I don't know if it's just gray water or if it's septic. I didn't. This wind was blowing, but it wasn't blowing in my favor, so
okay.
I don't know if we want to go visit people, or one of us, or send them a letter, or...
Well, I mean, if it's coming out of the ground, it's kind of serious. I would defer to DBS now if it's coming out of the ground. Let them see what they do.
Okay, so quality of all?
Yeah. Okay. Ask them.
What's some default letter material that Rebecca had supplied? And I haven't really gone through it, but there are some kind of steps, but I don't know. Certainly go to DES right now.
Yeah.
Maybe
okay.
We should refine this process a little in the future. So just know what, if there's anything we specifically should do. Maybe you've already answered that question in the past.
Call DES.
Call DES.
That's what we did with Jim Crow.
That's all I got on that. We'll just have Claudia call.
Yeah. All right. Okay, let's make a motion to approve the manifest of $28,237.35.
Second time.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Accept the minutes of June 13th work session. Make a motion to accept them.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
The minutes of the public hearing, June 4th. Well, I wasn't here for that. But
well, it started on May 30th. I actually joined the first one.
Yeah.
If you want to go longer or not.
May 30th. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Second.
Aye.
Yeah. Public hearing, June 4th, which I wasn't here, so.
I make a motion to accept the minutes.
Second.
Public hearing from 4th.
All in favor?
Aye.
All right. I know you had a typo on one of these. Selectmen's minutes, June 12th. Was that the one that you had a typo on?
Actually, it was one of the public.
Yeah. Not public.
Yeah, June 4th. Sorry, should have caught that earlier. Second paragraph, Chris. Selectman Cahalan discussed his reasons for wanting a repair plan as part of the easement agreement. He outlined what it's written here as want. So if you could just change that to what, please. And I'll re-motion to accept those minutes of June 4th public hearing as amended. Yeah. As amended.
Second.
All said.
Aye.
Okay. Make a motion to accept the minutes of June 12th.
I have a typo on that. First page, proposed work session and discussion. The fourth line is work session, work should be capitalized. Whether or not we should have budget committee member Eldridge in there, or just budget committee member, it doesn't matter to me. It doesn't say who we're meeting with. Tim is all right?
Yeah.
Okay, I'd like to amend that to be capital on word work, work session with budget committee member Tim, June 25th at 5 p.m.
Okay.
Motion to accept the 12th, June 12th yeah. minutes with the amendments.
Second. Okay.
Aye.
Non-public, accept the minutes of the non-public, June 12th.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay. All right. We're going to open it up to public comment. Any comment? Oh, well. Thank you.
I don't know if it was in your action for me, but I was in St. Claudia last week. In May, Dave Stroud, Jack Russell Road, ZBA chair, in May came to my attention that the process that ZBA is currently using for application approval may need to be looked at.
Oh yeah.
So in one of the conferences I went to, I talked to the conference attorney who handles ZBA matters, got an opinion, and gave me two options of what we could do. And then I talked to an OSI attorney last week, because that's the ones we use, gave them the same scenario, and she suggested that I ask from you to talk to our town attorney, or have you talk to the town attorney about the issue we have, how the ZBA gave us approving the application for hearing. So, either way, I mean, I'm looking at either I'll go email the town attorney or I can give you all the information. I think we ought to take the OSI's advice and just get the opinion from the town attorney. This is not in violation of the RSA.
So, I was probably the originator of all this conversation, I think, because I brought this up to the planning board, where in the statutes it specifically highlights the planning board should have their application noticed in the paper and to all the abutters when they're going to accept an application as complete or when they plan to review it for that process, which would prompt a second mailing and noticing on another night if you didn't move right into the hearing stage. So it doesn't specifically say ZBA, but one could infer that that process should carry over to the ZBA. I brought this to the attention of the planning board, who now post the notices that way. And I brought it to Dave, obviously, about the concerns there. Everything that I've heard so far doesn't say that it's a violation at the ZBA. It's a matter of staffing for every place that everyone I've talked to, because we don't have in-house staffing for planning boards and zoning and all that stuff here, like a bigger community. So one of the things they suggested was having an individual member of the board to review it, but that's kind of problematic.
Well,
it doesn't.
Yeah. I mean,
there's a little conflict there.
Before we get into how we would handle it, because if the attorney does say the current process 6767 doesn't apply to the ZBA, which is what the other attorneys basically told me it doesn't,
right,
then we're okay. We don't even have to go down that path.
Okay.
So I'd like to either just say let's ask the attorney, or you can ask the attorney. You know, what these two lawyers told me, well, as we put in our rules of procedure, while we're doing it, we're okay. You know, but our town attorney ought to be the one who's going to have to be defending it, ought to be notified how we're doing it.
Well, just as just to finish up where I was going with this, is ultimately, even if it's decided that it needs a review, I think that would fall to the planning board and the ZBA to find the administrative staff for that, because there's a budget for it. I personally don't have a problem with having the attorney get the question, and I think that should be from you. You're the ZBA chair, so that's your wheelhouse. But as far as the process for review, that, again, will probably fall to the individual boards, because there's a salary line.
If he says we have to do that, then I'll obviously be back before the board of how we want to put some suggestions about it. Do that, which I have some things in mind, but I think we're perfectly legal the way we're going right now.
I would agree.
I mean, she just wants a second check for the town attorney representative.
Now, who is Susan from OSI? I'm not familiar with Susan. Who's that?
Sorry?
Oh, she's not with OSI anymore. She's with Lakes Region Planning Commission.
Oh, okay.
She's been at New Hampshire. She's been at the Municipal Association. She gets around, yeah. Yeah, and the only other thing I'll just add to this is it's even problematic if the zoning enforcement officer was to do the reviews in kind of the same way as having an individual member review it. So just for you when you communicate with the attorney. So, I have reservations.
I have no problem contacting the town attorney by email. We'll call them. I don't know what your protocol is.
Either way, whatever makes it the most efficient is the protocol, I guess. The way I look at it.
It's probably, you probably get a hold of it quicker by email.
Quicker by email?
Yeah. Well,
I hate email because usually, you know, you can leave something out. But, I mean, I will.
No, try calling them, but sometimes it's easier to.
You okay with me calling them on this matter?
Yeah, I think it's, you have the right to do that as the ZBA. You need legal questions.
Well, she asked me to ask the board, so I did.
Well, we couldn't say no, as far as I understand.
Well, we could say no, but But I think it's legit. I applaud you for coming in front of us and saying you're going to call the town attorney instead of just we get a bill and all of a sudden you get blindsided.
I heard the budget committee don't like that.
I don't see any of that here.
So we're good with that?
Yeah.
I'll just get the number from Claudia unless you guys have it. You can give it to me.
I can give it to you. And sometimes it is easier to get your point across because there's multiple emails sometimes because there's a nuance missing. You get this half-page letter that he wrote that's not what you were talking
especially
about.
In your case, I think it's better to talk.
The grader went down my road yesterday, and it was calcium today.
I put a load out today. I don't know.
Oh, calcium?
Yeah. Looks like they went by my house.
Well, they saw that road was degrading, I'm sure.
Yeah.
I know a few lines, including my
I'm sure they did.
I just wondered based on the budget, what I'm going to be saying when we ask the budget, the actual quantity. So I wondered what percentage you guys knew was
done. I have a quote. You brought up a good thing. I'm going to call Allstate. I really got to get clarification on splitting the load. Because it's like taking medication. You split a bill, it doesn't really work.
I don't really think,
because the idea of calcium is to let it sit in the ground. If you're splitting it, you got to dig that stabilization that's already stable up again. I mean, I don't know if we're really getting the best bang for the buck.
Well, part of the conversation I had with him was that splitting the load, it's all kind of a scientific soils problem. Different soils react differently. So, I mean, I don't know what to tell you. If it's been working good, splitting the load is the way to,
no, I'm just saying, know. No, if it does, if he tells me it's good. You know, I just want to ask him, tell him my view. Because, I mean, it's like different medication. If he's supposed to take one pill, okay. You can't take a half a pill and expect it to work.
Well, that's where the soils, the composition makes a difference.
I know all that. That's
well, you get the
and rain is a big enemy to
right.
Calcium.
Oh, no.
It's good in the beginning and better in August. I mean, that's where we have been splitting up.
No, I know.
In the first grading.
But actually, as far as what they've got done, percentage-wise, I don't know. They're grading, and they put out calcium today. How much more to grade before they put out the rest of calcium?
Is it all complete by July 4th?
Oh, yeah.
I'm sure.
Yeah, probably this week. It depends on the calcium people.
You're expecting something like that. So when I pull a budget, then actually it should be close to complete.
I guess
it. First week of July.
I mean, this week's going to be good, so I don't see any reason that they couldn't finish this week. But that's
just get an idea. That's all I'm going to look at.
To tell you when it will be, I don't know.
Well, we just had a lot of We had a lot of billing for grading in materials in the folder tonight, but to put a running tab against the road to.
Lastly, did you discuss the request
philosophy? Oh, that was the, I don't have it in front of me now, for the schools. I think they wanted to have a committee put together to look into how
the formula.
Yeah, formula's budgeting. I believe it was stated it's been 55 years since there's been an actual review or a change to that policy.
65 was the original doctor, 64, 65, never been changed.
So the OSIP Board of Selectmen is looking for the various communities, the six communities, now I guess Middleton's part of it to some degree.
Yeah, I didn't realize Middleton was involved.
I think that was about
2 years ago. Yeah, all tuition. Well, they're not part of the district.
They pay.
Tuition they pay.
Yeah, the cash cap.
Yeah, they used to go to Farmington, but now they
can't.
So are they asking for the select board's approval to join that? I believe, they asking,
oh, they're asking, looking for a rep.
Yeah, they're asking if you're interested in the towns. In, like, you got, like, what we were going to have a budget committee, you know, oversee the school. That's what they're trying to get started, is to get a feeler out to see if the towns want to be part of this, you know, their own oversight. Not to say that Governor Wentworth is going to agree to it. I think it's still up to them.
Yeah.
You know, ultimately. But to show the school board that we are interested in, you know, interested in the budget, whether that happens or not, I don't know.
So was it two things they were asking for a budget and also for a review of the proration?
Well, not in front of me again. I think they're looking for a committee to be formed to review the process by which this is all we're being taxed.
Probation?
Yeah, I don't believe they put that in there as wording, but money's getting fine.
Oh,
well,
Thanks, buddy. I mean, they just want us to send them a letter saying, you know, we think it's a good idea. Or,
you support it or don't support it?
Yeah.
They're looking for investigating the methodology and calculating loss of share of the school district budget. It likely needs to be updated as the process for our town has not changed in 55 years, where he's asking each town and Governor Wentworth Regional School District, would you be in favor of establishing an actual budget committee with a representative from each town within the school district to provide financial oversight and review of the proposed budgets? We're looking for a response in writing no later than July 2nd. So the impact of a budget committee, as you know, because you're on ours, it's the same thing. There's a 10%, basically a 10% cap. So, but you can probably, like ours, the budget committee in town, you can probably whittle down what you're asking for.
Well, you can only make recommendations in the school board.
Yeah.
It's up to them if they decide to take recommendations.
Is that how their budget committee would work? I thought it was the same.
In the RSAs that I looked at, that's what I was understood. I mean, I have to go back and look. It's been many years since I've sent one of their meetings. So
it's been 8 years since I looked at it, so I'm sure you're more current.
I mean, if I was reviewing the proportion formula, if they definitely want to do that, I would highly recommend that I would support it. I mean, I've sent through numerous meetings with the school board and finance committee and presentations. I have given them options besides review of the proportion formula, which they don't want to change. But they didn't seem to have any other alternatives to try and fix the solution. So I'm firmly supportive of reviewing the proportion formula, simply committed to do that. And I would definitely volunteer to go on that committee.
Well, in my opinion, just me, I would say we should write back and say we would support it. We support it.
And we'd have a volunteer before he says no.
Yep.
I mean, I'm talking for a review of the proportion for that.
And, well, they're looking for somebody to serve on a budget committee as well. But certainly, we'll go in steps, given what we have.
I think this is all if Governor Wentworth approves.
I'm not sure, but I would do a review.
They have to approve the budget committee.
Do they?
So
I'm going to look it up. I don't think they get to
the approve articles from the budget committee. They have to put the articles from the as establishment of the budget committee. I think that has to be voted in.
Right.
Yeah.
Exactly. This isn't a given, then.
But they're the ones who put the warrant articles on.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
The ballot.
On the ballot.
Right. Because they're SB2, so it has to go on the ballot.
Correct.
But the budget committee, I would imagine, has oversight on the operating budget, just the same as they do here, wouldn't they?
I would imagine it would be the follow-up to a vote.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. I think it works the same way. So, if every town has had their issues with this and the impacts. I mean, some towns, their tax rate for this are extremely lower, but they tend to be the towns that donate more money in. I mean, I wouldn't mind seeing the whole thing like that.
We've got nothing to lose by joining it.
Yeah.
No.
Because we're only going to be seeing increases fluctuate greatly, even more now, as their budget gets bigger.
Exactly.
I'm trying to explain to them that but it's so high now, that's why the small towns are seeing the huge fluctuations.
Yeah.
But the percentage in Ossipee's is starting to creep in, and Ossipee really crept in. And it's going to keep going. And it's basically end up with two that won't see fluctuations, and all the others will. And you're going to see big swings for our small towns. And I don't mean a dog. You're going to see a lot more bigger swings than that if they keep going at the current method.
Well, there again, I support the review of this because I know that it was just even a few years back, it was 2/3 of our town's taxation was on education. Whether it was part of it was the school tax, which I believe goes right back to the school systems anyway. But I could be wrong.
It is just smoke and mirrors. That's actually what we pay the school.
That's what
the state pays it for us. So.
Yeah, we pay the state and they hand it over.
Yeah, I mean, we're still paying that amount of money, adding in the state. Whether the school takes that off and says you're only paying this every month. You're paying $2 and the state's paying $3 of your share. You don't pay $5 every month, you only pay $2. That's what we're really paying.
Well, the education tax all balled together, which shows up on our tax rate, is probably somewhere in the neighborhood of $14 today. I can't tell you.
It's a little better than $13 last I checked. I mean, I'd have to check.
So that's almost basically 2/3 of our property taxes. So I'd like a little more oversight's not going to break my heart. All right, so we'll put that on the list of things to accomplish. Still got the floor, Dave?
You got it.
No, that's the one I wanted.
Mr. Regal, do you have anything? Do you have anything? We're in public comment.
Yeah,
sure.
Speaking as a member of the Effingham Preservation Society on the subject of the granite slabs at the transfer station. I'm wondering when we can gain possession of.
I got an email today from Leo Lucien.
Yeah.
Did you guys get that too?
No.
No? Okay. Leo was pointing out on August 15, 2017, there was a deal for granite slabs for $1 for some of the town's nonprofits.
They have a copy of the minutes of that.
Right. And it's just a one liner, I think, right, Steve? Is that?
Yes, this was actually a follow up to discussions that had happened on a couple of previous selectmen's meetings in regards to the slabs. Because at that point, this was back in August, it was at the time when the town was going to look into selling the land and realize it had, we're going to move these slabs off of it. At that time, we asked that we could gain, you know, 4 of those slabs for UPS for work that needs to be done there, and also a slab for the Historical Society, which we were going to use at the normal school. At that meeting, Bob Battles was here from Digging Goats, and he said that he would deliver them free of charge. At that point, we hadn't come up with any sort of remuneration, it was just a matter of, okay, we can have it. What happened then was, over the next couple of weeks, it came to light that we should have some sort of a charge for them. It couldn't be just a blind transfer or town property. Then at that meeting, on the 15th, it was agreed by the three selectmen that the fee of $1 each slab would show that they were in fact sold to historical entities, and that any other slabs there would be dealt with by the town as a per-need basis, meaning if there was another entity within the town that needed them, then maybe the same deal could be worked. If not, if the town decided that they would sell them, then they would do that with interested parties. But it laid it out that the initial slabs would be sold to EPS, four of them, and one of them to the Historical Society. Now, since then, the slabs have been moved to the transfer station. So a couple of the markings have come off of them, you know, that I had, because I went that next day and marked the slabs, and there was one already marked for the Historical Society. But that's not a big deal. Whatever can be worked out, you use me as a resource to identify the slabs that we would need. Okay. So that's where we are now. We just need the impetus to go ahead and get rolling on this so we could get them over there and get our work commenced.
I don't have a problem with, you know, with the, I think, dollar amount. What was it, dollar?
Yeah.
Dollar each.
Yeah.
Now, when I spoke to you in private a couple of weeks ago about the slabs, you said that you would need something from the Preservation Society. I believe that Karen emailed you something.
I never got anything, but it doesn't really matter if it's in the minutes that you said it to myself or a dollar or somebody.
Oh. No, this was just a couple of weeks ago.
I didn't get it.
No. Because I have the email that I sent her, and then her response back, I mentioned that you would want something in writing. And then she says, okay, I just sent something off. That was May 23rd. She sent it to the selectman's office. Christine, did you get that?
I'm sorry. Repeat, please.
May 23rd.
Yeah.
Karen Payne said that she had sent something to the selectman's office and hoped that it would be enough.
Yeah, I haven't received anything better.
We'll look into the office for that.
Yeah, I think it's a moot issue anyway. Because we said we're gonna sell it to you for a dollar, you were gonna go down and mark them. And I remember Bob Battle saying that he would take them over.
Yeah.
Now that they've gone to the transfer station, I haven't gone down into that area because it's been none of my business at that point. That's why I came to you the other day and asked, what should we do? And then you wanted it to be official. So now I believe that we're at the point where it is official. And I believe Chuck brought up last week the fact that they were still looking for that one for the normal schools. So that's both organizations.
Well, I wasn't on the board at the time, but wasn't there a little bit of a pecking order? Somebody was picking first, somebody got the next one or something. Does anybody
know? It doesn't really matter.
Al picked out one for the normal school, and I don't know, somebody picked out.
I picked them
Steve
out.
Steve three.
Leo and I went, we just got them.
And we decided nonprofits would sell them for a buck, because you can't just give town property away.
Yeah.
So Henry and I, and it was you, right?
Yeah.
We decided on a dollar piece for the nonprofits. And Bob said he had haul them, so I mean, once they're paid for, I'd say get a hold of Bob and make arrangements with him to get them.
You know, well, that's why I went to John. John said, "Don't call Bob."
No, we got to call Bob. We got to call Bob and tell him that's okay to move the slabs. I don't want townspeople going to Bob. It's our decision. So if it comes, it's better for us to call Bob and say, Bob, listen, you might be getting a call from Mr. Regal for the preservation, you know, the slabs, blah, blah, blah. So that call should come from us, not from him.
Well, yeah.
Whatever you guys decide, I'll work with him.
I agree. That's my point.
Do we have an inventory on what's there in case somebody else is in the wings who wants this so that we have a supply for anyone else? Or
so we can go downtown?
There's a lot of it there.
There's a lot of it there.
Yeah. Okay.
To my knowledge, we've been the only two entities that have expressed.
Yeah. We're the only ones. So,
so the others would be town property, which would be a town assets.
Right.
Yeah.
Who wants to make the call?
However you guys decide to work out with Paul,
I
can work with that, Lenny, and I'll have person or I think it was his son who was going to be involved. It was maybe Josh or something like
that. I don't know why we get a call, Bob, because, I mean, it's the Preservation Society, the Historical Society. So, I mean, I think it'd be up to them to set up transportation.
I just think because they're not town, they're separate entities. They are, historic and preservation.
Yeah, I mean, it's...
They have nothing to do with town property, per se.
Well, once they buy it, it's their property. Once they pay for it.
Well, I think it doesn't hurt to have the board talk to Bob about it because it's on town property, and it is at the moment town property, and it just avoids everybody under the sun calling Bob with a semi-town related business. Once this board says to Bob, here's what we're doing, this is what we give the okay for, after that I'd say it's between the other parties, but I think the initial might be
Bob.
The heads up to Bob probably should come from us.
Because Bob doesn't own Steve Reese. Hey, listen, I want you to own some slabs.
I think it covers the base. That's
protocol.
Yeah.
Right.
You can let me know how you make up with that.
I will. Yeah. I'll call tomorrow.
With next steps.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
In the meantime, I can speak with the historical people to find out where they want their slab moved to, whether it be with ours or brought directly to the normals or whatever they plan to do with it.
Because I'm sure it's only going to be a one move.
Bob can't be trucking this stuff around forever.
Yeah.
I understand that.
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, so I'll call Bob tomorrow. And then I'll let you know.
Thank you.
No problem.
Thank you, boy.
Do you have contact information for somebody?
What?
Steve, do you have contact
information? No, okay. Anything else?
Well, we're talking about the Preservation Society. Saturday's a street fair.
Oh, that's right, the street fair.
Yeah.
The townhouse will be closed.
Connor Road get closed in too?
No, that's the detour.
That's the detour.
Yeah.
Just from Connor Road down to the intersection of 153. And that's only until 1 o'clock, I believe. Either 12 o'clock or 1 o'clock.
Yeah, I think it's 2:02.
9:02.
For the record, that's Edith Shaw.
Yes. And we're glad to see you.
You jump right in. I don't know if you need that.
While we're talking about road closure, Melissa asked if it'd be possible to close it on the 240th. Birthday party there in August. It's going to be at the Preservation Society.
What date is August?
So it'd be a Saturday.
Well, they want to have it down by the Preservation Society?
They're going to have it at the Preservation Society.
Yeah,
so, I mean, there'll be a lot of dignitaries and places for people to walk and gather and talk.
Dignitaries?
Yeah.
Huh? Who's going?
It's a camp. It's a election year. There'll be all kinds of people there. You wouldn't say.
Sure.
Governor can't make it, but I'm sure he'll send somebody in his spot.
Is that the same Clojure townhouse at corner?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll see where I can. But if you can have her put that in writing.
Yeah, okay. Just a reminder, I got to leave in about 15 minutes.
That's why I'm checking. I keep looking up and I'm saying, oh my God. If there's no other public comment, we're going to go on to selectmen's comments and reports. We have to kind of expedite this a little bit because Lenny has to go to the school and we have that public hearing. I got in touch with the crack sealing company. I'm going to meet with them probably Thursday morning around 6 or 7. He's going to call me tomorrow to set up a time. It's 5,500 pallet. I just want to make sure that this is clear. Hutchess Bridge is the most important one that we want to do, or no?
Yeah, that's what you get down.
Well, no, I have one. I have, but
I didn't say my priority.
I thought it was townhouse. That'd be number one.
Townhouse Road? I
you know what I recall, John, is I think what we were considering is the entrance into the town. If they might have been coming in on Hunters first because it's so far away, but that's all I remember.
Okay, so Townhouse Road is first?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Old Town is second?
It's right there.
Oh, you got it?
Yeah.
Perfect. Townhouse, okay. Townhouse is first. Okay. First. Well, we're going to have to move this around because he's not going to go from Hunter's Bridge.
Sure.
Townhouse to Hunter's back to Old Town. So.
Well, I thought it was just a matter of lining them up and knocking them down in order.
Yeah, I would say he's coming in Hunter's. I left a message for Tri-State Bridge, the painter. I told him to cancel that. Yeah. He hasn't called. I don't expect a call back, but I did leave a message to hold off because you don't have to paint the bridge because the steel doesn't have to be painted. It's what kind of steel is that?
Weathering.
Weathering?
Weathering.
Weathering steel does not need to be painted. So we saved $31,000 now, or $34,000.
That's Elm Street Bridge?
Yes. So did you, you're probably going to talk about this anyway. HEB, did you get a contract from them? Update on the fire station and Elm Street Bridge. Did you get anything from them?
Fire station.
The septic.
Oh, I called Landtech today for the septic, but there was nobody in the office, so I didn't get an update today. HEB did send like a 33-page document just before we started tonight. I haven't even got to read it, so I'm not sure what it's outlining for a scope on Elm Street. I did have a conversation with him this afternoon before he sent that material, and it was essentially covering a couple of things. One was Elm Street and whether the things that are happening structurally with the bridge could be done for the money that we have available this year, if it should be separated out to two projects, or if we should probably schedule it all for next year because of big contractors like a bigger job. So they're still working on the absolute scope. And again, I haven't got to read what came in yet. So that'll tell more. The other thing I did get as an update, which was just crazy, was the little culvert down the street. The culvert is actually considered into the right-of-way of the road. The travel portion normally wouldn't be there by today's standards. And that, along with some other things with the curvature of the road and such and the speed, makes the guardrails very problematic. They're still investigating some different ways to do guardrails, but by today's standards, it's just astronomical amount of guardrail that they would have to put there, because it's an engineering thing that says there's a certain amount of footage you'd have to put a post right in the center of that guardrail. But you can't put, the center of the culvert, but you can't put one there. So by extending it off to the edges, it extends the entire length of the guardrail. And it was a ridiculous amount of length at this time, as well as cost to do it the way the standards call for. The other thing is it's either a NASH or a SMASH. I think it's a NASH study review that deals with guardrails is up for some changes next year. Maybe that could shed some light. And then there's a forestry type of guardrail that's typically a little shorter than what we need here, and they're going to look into that. So there's more coming from them, and there's stuff in the office for you guys to get a copy, review, or report on it next week. And also, though, it does have a timeline to put out the repairs for Elm Street for a certain amount of the scope for this year. It does have a point in July to send it out. I think it was the 16th, advertised until somewhere in August, and then we could move forward, which I'm sure that's going to be the steel repair and the expansion joint and the cracks under the pedestal supporting that. But it wouldn't be involving the deck. So I know that that's been put together, so we have an RFP that could go out. But without having an opportunity to read it, I can't say too much more.
Okay, we did. Thank you for ordering those culverts for Green Mountain Road. We did go out and look at all that and measure them. Mike ordered them the next day. And he got a really good deal on it.
We decide where we're going to have them delivered?
Yeah, to his place.
Yeah,
to his place.
Delivery to
Bob's.
Digging
down.
Yeah,
it's about down for you.
And just because we have like Dave and the audience here, what John needs really good pricing was, we didn't have to shop around. Culverts are an item on the state's bid list, priced out. So the price savings was about 45% per foot on the culverts, which was just crazy.
Do we have, I know we have to look into this, who are we going to have to oversee in the first part of Green Mountain Road?
Is there funding for engineering, and to what level if there is?
There's funding for engineering, yeah. Professional services.
Maybe we should get a couple of proposals to see what they're willing to do for what are we asking them to do. Because we've got White Mountain Survey, that HUB, there might be somebody else.
Well, White Mountain, I can tell you, is $100 an hour. Wouldn't exceed $5,000, so if I have it in my notes. But I'll call them again. I mean, that's who did Townhouse. Mark and Lucy, you drive through the town every day to go home.
No.
We have, you know, somebody who should have somebody at least do the first half.
Sure.
Do the first half. You know. And this way we can see where we're going to be.
I think that was brought up at a few meetings that we're going to have an engineer oversee.
Yeah, well, of course.
Yeah.
Lawrence brought it up.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Should I have an engineer as well?
But okay, this. You wanted me to call White Mountain?
Yeah, and see if they just put some kind of a proposal in writing so we know what we're getting, what they're willing to do on the project, what they're going to look at.
Do you know the guy? You know the guy from Atlanta? I don't know. Is that
yeah, Brian. Carlin, yep.
You want to call him?
Yeah, I'll call him too.
I don't know him, so.
Sure.
I mean, it doesn't really matter, but.
Yeah. My big concern is just making sure the road goes back where it was, which I don't think that's going to be too much of a problem with reclamation.
No, they
have
to pin it culverts. First. That's all they got to do. They got to pin it a little.
Right.
First. That's the big thing.
And then that the culverts go in the appropriate fashion with the right amount of pitch.
Yeah. Well.
That is properly.
So this is who is going to survey Green Mountain Road?
Engineer, who's going to oversee. The first part of Green Mountain.
Right. Civil Engineering Services for Green Mountain Road Project.
That's all I got. Lenny, what you got?
Well, Dick talked to you about adding a berm at the transfer.
Yeah,
another fire berm. So one gets full, they can burn it. Fill the other one up while that one's waiting to cool off so we don't end up like having fire for a whole week down there. So,
second pit, you mean?
Yeah, just,
he said he
only need
there was one behind it.
I don't remember. It could be, I don't know if it was behind it or not. I don't remember. But,
yeah. That's what
he said at one
you
time.
You probably wouldn't remember.
Yeah.
I haven't been here.
He said we had to at one time, and we may have. It was just a suggestion, on his part that, that way they're not piling brush in on hot coals and stuff. So, it was just a recommendation, and we can talk about that. Probably not in this year's budget, but, and no beavers this week, so everything's cool.
Father's Day, that's why.
So keep an eye on them little critters, but. And other than that, I get nothing.
I just got one other thing I forgot. I went to the transfer station Saturday, and I was looking for a place to put the glass. Where they put that fence, where the compactor used to be, if we got a 30-yard dumpster, we might be able to slide that right in there and not block the other, and cut that fence down, and throw the glass in there so you just drop it in. And then they can go. When it gets too, because a lot of people, like Mark said, it can go underneath. You can slide that underneath a little bit. It's, get a construction dumpster is what it is. I mean, I don't know how much glass. I'm sure you can hold a lot of glass in it. It's probably going to break to pieces.
Yeah.
So I to get started on the glass, that's the only place that I saw that you could put it. Not because you don't want people throwing it over the top, not especially not glass. That's not. I would not. That would never fly.
Yeah, and you don't want to put a set of stairs up either.
No. So I mean, I don't know. Take a measurement of a 30-yard dumpster. See if you can throw it in there. And an RA might throw one in there, and just cut that fence down a little, or just take the chain link and just cut the chain link. Leave a post there, and just cut the chain link halfway down, so they can't fall over, but yet they still can drop the glass down. I don't know. That was my observation.
Well, I can.
And the water, and the water, I think, is a good. If we could put a polyethylene pipe down there, put a spigot right on the hill down at the bottom, so they could run a hose or whatever. So they do have, God forbid, something like that should happen—a fire. They have water. I mean, and just get a jet pump and just pull it out, for the winter. And just store it.
You should be able to shut it down and blow out the line.
Just blow it out. I was looking at that, but that's a good idea just to see if, just keep it on that hill. Just run the pipe on the hill. You don't want to bury them up.
You're going to have a fire, and we want to have water available. I'm in with that.
Yeah. So that was the two things. That's all I have. I know you've got to go with that. But,
I'm willing to go measure out that 30 yard because part of what I saw was it I'm thinking it's going to interfere with the steel, the metal container. And the option to that, I was thinking, was putting the metal container over closer to where we keep all the white goods. Because I met with Marilyn Ware from NRRA the other day on site. And she said, once you have the Freon extracted, or items without Freon in them, those can go right in to the metal container. So if you swung the door open on the metal container, you could actually bring things in and stack it that way and close the door at the end if you have.
I'm just not cool with people walking in the dumpster. That's just not cool with it. That's a liability, a cut or something like that. The Northeastern Recycling would drop a container off next to the white goods. And you can fill up that.
Instead of fencing.
Yeah.
Once the Freon.
Yeah, once the Freon, and just roll that, and they have a hand truck. I'm all right with that, because what our guys are going to do, roll the refrigerator, the reefers and stuff into that bin.
Yeah.
And then when it's full, you call them, they come and haul it out. You know, so I mean, but as far as people walking in the dump, I just think that's an accident waiting to happen.
Yeah, but if they fill the dumpster, then they got to move them out so the guy can get in there to drain out the Freon.
No, this is after the Freon is gone.
You need 25 units to be extracted.
Yeah, before they come, you have to have 25 so they can come to minimum 25, I think. So if you have 25 and you had a container right there, once it's extracted, you put them in a container, you roll them in, whoever rolls it in, and then you just fill up the green container. I mean, I think that's just a safety issue for me, is having people throw stuff, walk into a dumpster and throw. That's just me.
All right, then we're back at trying to make sure we have a good location for that 30-yard, because the savings is just too big to
ignore. Yeah, I don't think it's going to interfere with the metal container at all. I think it's just going to pass, you know, put it up, you know, because Mark said, yeah, but, you know, if it gets, where they dump it over and it mounds up, he just pushes it, you know, they have one of the ramp pushes, whatever the hell, a makeshift ramp.
Reverse snow rake?
Yeah, exactly, yeah, only made of steel, and they just push the glass, you know, flatten it out, and just keep filling it up. I mean, that's, for me, that would be the easiest way. I don't know if you can get away with 30 yards.
Yeah, I think that's usually what we'd end up getting.
I don't know.
I don't think people give out the 40s too readily.
Or even construction. What is a construction? 30 yards?
30.
Yeah, 30. I mean, to get that glass thing going, you know, get that.
Yeah.
Start it right away.
Yeah.
You know, and just.
I actually got an email from Marilyn Ware again today discussing a few things that she sent. And I sent back that I was looking to get that proposal sooner than later on the glass and verify all the prices and, you know, all of what it involves.
I mean, we wouldn't have to really do that all. Sure. What else you got, Lane? Sorry.
No. Okay. That's it. Graduation.
Yeah, graduation.
Finally made it through the sixth grade. Good for you. I'm proud.
Only taking me 3 tries.
Yeah.
I know we had something in the action folder for A&B Lock last week. When Brian was asked to go down and look at the library/town hall building, it was just basically make all the keys, all the locks have the same key. I guess there's key for this, a key for that, key for the next thing. So in discussion with him, once he showed up on site, someone there directed him to conversationally just morph.
Lenny, thank you so much.
Yeah. It morphed into a more elaborate system. So I did explain to him, I don't think that we're prepared to go with that this year. And he felt that it would probably be you know, under $200 or something to do all the locks, and I don't know if that was including the door closure.
I don't believe so.
I don't believe so either.
I think it's $80 a lock to charge to, 80 or 85 to repeat.
Well, it said under 200 to redo the library locks, to make them all unified. So,
he's giving me a good deal.
When he shoots us back a proposal, you'll know what it's about now, because somebody took a left turn on that.
Okay. See, that's what happens when it expands, when certain people aren't there. They kind of, it's like the rubber band. They just stretch it.
Dad gave out the credit card, and the kids went, wild.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
So signs, there's been some signs ordered, and when we move into glass and such at the transfer station, there'll be more signs that we need to order to specifically take glass out of the recyclable sign there and put glass over here, and explaining that glass doesn't mean windows and everything else, it's glass containers. So more signs. Other than that, I don't have too much tonight, John. You talked about a lot of it. Some of it I'm waiting for.
Oh my God, Elizabeth, this is.
We do want to follow up with the office, because I didn't get an answer to this one. There was a judgment or a finding, an agreement, perhaps is a better term, that we had struck with a property owner in town. And attorney fees were part of that. Well, the attorneys got paid, but there was also a portion to the town for $500 that I have yet to hear back that we've received that check. So just to put that on your radar. The energy audit people have been in touch with me, but it's been a while, so unless something came to the office scheduling that, I have no more communications on that one. And that, I was interested in discussing with the board, although Lenny left, in getting more information from the zoning officer about activities in the town. Things for us and things for the planning board that would highlight maybe a different colored form for building permits or a building application for non-residential commercial uses, to a little easier to identify that in the pile. And for all of those activities on non-residential commercial issues and things that are going on in the town to get highlighted or delivered to us and to the planning board. Yeah, we've got a few in-house things that we should probably schedule a session with the zoning officer to see if some of this is doable.
This is what other towns do. I can't really...
It emphasizes certain
parameters and
permits and verifications that are outside the town's purview, but the town probably has a responsibility to make sure we gain those before any activities or permits are issued, which has always been something that I've advocated for. But John's highlighted it in that nice little article from a neighboring town.
You're saying we don't do this, John?
What's that?
You're saying we don't do this?
No, I'm saying we should do that.
We thought we did.
We thought we did. But we don't. I have yet to see any of that on a form.
Notice of decision?
Yeah.
Not on your notice of decision.
That's a variance for conditions that was a grant.
Yeah,
but conditional.
Yeah, variance for conditions,
and
granted, that's all it is.
If it's a notice from your board, it lists all of those things, or it's in the paperwork in more detail. What I thought was being shared here was that we need, from the municipal standpoint, without the planning board or the ZBA, is to have established that shoreline protection permits or septic system design approvals.
Exactly.
Are in-house.
That's what all that is. That's just to show how other people.
Yeah, but that's all that is a planning board. That's a zoning board approval of a variance with conditions. That's all it is. That's something the zoning board ever does.
Well, they didn't approve it until the conditions are met, and then it's approved.
final approval.
Final approval.
Well, yeah, that's how you get the approval. Yeah. They set the variance with conditions, and they approve these conditions.
Well, let's just say my concerns aren't with that. I understand that. What I was taking away is highlighting that certain conditions, certain approvals, have to be taken from the state before this town should issue a building.
Yeah, that's exactly what that was for. Yeah.
That's a different notification. Yeah.
Right, but it highlights that that's part of the process. So, anyway, some discussion to be had in-house. We'll set a work session, I guess, on that one when we can coordinate.
Yeah,
might have. And Rebecca. Other than that, I think that there's two ordinances that are selectmen's town ordinances that could go on to the website, and that's for outdoor public events, and then that's the other one is for septic systems and the process to which they are governed by the town, involves a lot of the town health officers. So I don't know if you've had an opportunity to go through them or if you just want to post them, because it would take a public hearing for us to amend anything.
I did go through a couple.
Okay.
I don't have a problem with the outdoor ordinance events. That's been in there.
I think we can clear up the Scribner's error on there. Of ticket is not one word. Of tickets.
If you're okay with the septic one, or should we did anything? I'm just wondering if any changed from that. Should we call subsurface and just ask? Has anything changed from? Because that's old.
Well, that the other one, I think I gave Lenny absconded with my copy last week, so I can go through it again and look match it to the environmental ordinances and see if we have a conflict. If I don't. I'll bring it back. And I don't think it actually addresses state requirements. It's more of a town requirements. But I'll go through it again, bring it back to you. There's a typo in there, which I don't know if we'd have to have a public hearing to change water to the obvious wastewater, but it's the one thing I saw in there, which is significant. Again, I don't really have too much this week, and I think there are people just waiting for public
comment. Go ahead, go for it.
Chuck Fuller, Effingham Historical Society. I'm following up on an item from last August.
A lot of that tonight.
Where apparently...
don't tell me. Granite Slabs.
Granite Slabs were...
Oh, no, I do it!
August 15th, 2017. I basically said Granite Slabs would be sold for $1 each to nonprofit organizations, Preservation Society, and an Historic Society for the Normal School. I've traded emails with Preservation Society. They want three of them.
Four.
I need one of them.
Four.
Four?
Leo told me to pay three.
$1.
You have $1 in it?
Leo emailed me earlier in the day. Leo. Mr. Regal has been here all day on this issue already. Of course, he didn't offer any money then.
All right, so preservation is four now?
Yeah. Yep.
Four.
And historical's one.
I think you'll need to take your funding to the office where they can provide a receipt.
Oh, you mean you guys can't take funds?
You
no.
need to have a written receipt to make this legal.
Are you kidding me?
I'll just take blood.
You touch that money, there's going to be a state investigation. You know it.
Notice I'm just looking at it. I ain't going near it.
No way. Nice try.
Nice try, yeah. Mr.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Pleasure doing business with you.
He used to be a police officer. I think they call that entrapment.
No, I gotta tell you, a lot of shady cops around.
Ooh, you're on your own on that one. I gotta drive home.
Not up here.
That was a New York comment, right?
Yes. Or whatever. City.
Yeah, sure. Joe? John is going to get a hold of Bob Battles, tell him that it's all right for me. He's going to do a one-time shipment.
Okay.
All right? You need to know where you are. Slabs you go, should go with ours to EPS, or should it go to the normal?
I wouldn't want to be carrying them.
Okay.
I traded with you, I don't care about going down to the market.
Right.
Paul Miller actually helped me measure out. There's only one stone down there.
After this, Tom, we're going to have a meeting.
I'm going to knock the others,
okay,
and then I will actually see if I can be with him when he goes and does the...
Heavily spray paint your color on the granite so that you can...
Yeah, all over it.
Yeah. Don't.
Ink is good color. Yeah.
Tag it, right?
I know some good taggers from Brooklyn. They'll make that thing look...
You don't have to go all the way to Brooklyn.
Ah, the best ones are in Brooklyn.
So, I think you're going to get your wish, both of you, tonight. So, anything else?
Anything else?
I have a general question.
Does it have to do with slabs?
No.
Okay.
It has to do with culverts.
Say to Henry.
I'm talking about the small ones, you know, that are forever along the roads that are plugged up. Every year you got to have them blown out. Are there any kind of grates that can be installed on the uphill of these culverts that would keep the massive stuff out, and it would be much easier to clean those out at that point each year rather than have to go through the whole rigmarole of not only digging them out each year but then trying to dig out the culvert?
Catch basins are problematic. Very problematic. And that's why they're doing away with them.
Catch basins, you got to clean them out.
Yeah.
We never say, do.
No, but, well, first of all, how are you going to clean them out? With a shovel? With sand?
They're not easy.
That's why they're problematic. That's why they're doing away with them. And actually, they're doing away with culverts, and they're just making swales in the road. You know, paved swales. That's what they're doing. It just.
I just wanted to know, because it seems like every year we talk about that everything backs up, and they're going to be blown out. And
I agree, 100%.
I'll tell you, Steve, what I've observed is that we don't do any real ditching that's comprehensive enough to locate the ends of our culverts. Therefore, they're not getting cleaned out.
Right.
It's only when something happens and a problem comes up.
Right.
And like on Drake Road this year, Karen Payne contacted us because there was a culvert seemingly overflowing problem. So this goes to the idea of a grate. When we had the contractor go down there, it wasn't plugged up at all. The end of the culvert where your grate would be was just all full of sticks and leaves, and that had diverted the water. So it doesn't come with a total solution. We also, and I got an email from Susan Slack at Lakes Region Planning, and I've had this conversation before, is that they will, for a price, come in and hopefully identify where all your culverts are. And then list them on GPS, which I think we as a community need to start doing the GPS listing with the culverts we've identified on Green Mountain Road and Townhouse Road, the roads we've reconstructed. And that's a great idea. Problem part is we've neglected our culverts for so long, locating them is not that easy. So we may pay, you know, $2,500, $5,000 to come in and locate some of them. But we certainly wouldn't get all of them because through multiple visits on Green Mountain Road, we continually found some more. And it, like Tim White's house, I said, this is a place we should have one. Because I just saw water seeping. Well, Mr. White's on another board. I happened to be there one night. And he said, hey, you missed one of those culverts because it's right where I thought it should go. And I went out there to stake it, and I dug around, and I can't find the culvert. So unless, you know, we do some better ditching maybe and ding the ends of these things.
How about marking? Once they are found, how about
John
marking?
John wants to do that with delineator signs.
Yeah.
About that, but until we
just as an example, you know, I'm right off of Drake Road.
Yep.
If I knew that there was a problem up on Drake Road with a culvert, I knew exactly where it was. I'm not against going up there with a shovel and a rake and cleaning out the uphill of it. But I'm not going to go dig up the whole side of the road looking for it. Once you find it, let's not reinvent the wheel. Mark it, and we know where it is.
Well, that's the process that John wants to follow on Green Mountain Road. He put stakes there for the initial, and once we dig them up and do the road over, delineator stakes will go in with a color coat on them. The one drawback there is every spring is an attrition that needs to be taken into consideration and potentially remarked. Plowing is what it is.
It is what it is.
But, yep, that is part of the plan, is to delineate the culverts.
Yeah, if you put the delineator far enough off the road,
you would hope.
You know, back in, it wouldn't be subject to, say, a snowbank or a pushback.
Or you can do what the state does, put a yellow stripe right on the road.
Yeah,
that's what they do.
But I think you'd find that more than one citizen would be willing to help alleviate the problems, you know, if they knew where the uphill of the culvert was.
That's the plan. Do it once.
I'm still not too sure he sold me on the idea of going on the dirt road to paint the stripe, though.
They have dirt paint.
They have dirt paint?
Well, I wasn't aware. I hate painting, so look at that.
You get that line. Didn't you ever play baseball?
I think you got to keep putting the line back.
Not if you do it right.
Besides, when I was a kid, we had an outhouse, so that's where the line was.
Wow.
All right.
On that note. No comment on that one. Now, sometimes silence is the best defense. But if you want to exasperate on it more.
Exasperate. I'm exasperated enough.
All right. Any other public comment?
All right.
Well, make a motion to adjourn.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thanks all for coming.
It's against my nature to do that. You know that.
I was impressed. I think it's the first time I've heard that. Yeah. And